Hello everyone, Karma here, and today I'm answering 10 questions that you guys have sent me in my last video and in previous videos. There was maybe 20 questions, so I am going to have to do two parts to this. The first 10 that I answered are not in any particular order, so please don't be mad if I did not get to your question in this video, but I will get to it in the next video. Also, I want to thank everyone who are watching my videos and everyone who subscribed. I am now at 1,000 subscribers. Yay! And I appreciate it. If you guys want, suggest any kind of content that I can give to you guys, then I will provide that for y'all. I'm trying to get as many videos uploaded as possible while I have this time off. Also, I want to say thank you to all the questions that you guys have left me in my teaching videos, because some things I'm like, wow, I can't believe I left that out, or, oh, that's an awesome question. So thank you guys for your support. Thank you guys for your love. Thank you guys for subscribing, and let's get started on answering these questions. All right, ladies, so let's get started. I'm going to start with question number one. It is, was it challenging writing IEPs with no experience? And yes, it was. From the beginning of the school year to the very end, I was having problems. Now, it did get better. I did have to go back and see what other teachers written. And a lot of the time, I did go and ask, you know, mentors and other teachers across the school. So I would start a goal, see if it sounded right, and then I would go ask. And if it sounded good to multiple people, at least two people, I was just like, all right, you know, I got my validation. This goal's going to stick. But yes, it was challenging. So don't think it's just going to come up, you know, pop up, you know, overnight. And it's still challenging for some veteran teachers, special education teachers. So yes, it was a challenge. But luckily I did have people that I can go to and ask. So hopefully that answered your question. And if you have people, definitely go and ask. Question number two, does Texas Teacher assist in finding you a job? Now, Texas teachers did not sit up and say, hey, we're going to send your resume to this school. You know, they want to interview you, blah, blah, blah. They didn't do any of that. But what they did do was they did email me and let me know what places were hiring, or the schools would email me saying they were hiring for a special education teacher and you can apply. So they do send you emails about, you know, this, and it's across Texas. So they'll send me somewhere from Del Rio. They'll say this school's hiring a special education teacher. All this was going on during my, after I passed my SPED test towards, you know, the end. So yes, they did send, you know, potential job openings to me. And I think they sent it to everyone else. Question number three. Did you have to wait a certain time after you were done with the Texas Teacher Program to get a job? I did not. Now, the reason why I did, I don't think you have to. I think as soon as you're done, you can apply. Like, you can apply to any school. But I did not have to, because the school that I'm at, I was a TA for 2 years. And during that 2 year period, I was getting my SPED certification, and doing the Texas Teacher Program. After that towards the end of that second year, one of the teachers was not coming back the next year. So I automatically got the job, because of course I'd been there for 2 years, and you know, it's like, oh, this girl's been here. We'll just hire her as a teacher. She already has her teacher certification. So for me, I just was grandfathered in, I guess. I just was like, oh, you've been here. This teacher's not coming back next year. Boom, you're the teacher now. So, but you don't have to wait a certain time. I think once you're done with the program, you just start applying, like, period. And even, I just had my school only, it's a charter school. So all I really needed was a special education certification to get in. I didn't even need the generalist done yet. In some schools, you do have to have the generalist test done. So luckily for me, I just needed to pass that SPED test and I was in. Question number four. Let's see. How much is starting salary in Texas? Honestly, I have no clue. It varies across the entire state. It's pretty big, y'all. It varies. Some is dirt low and some is like super high, and it also depends on your experience. So of course, if you're a 10-year vet teacher, and then there's a first-year vet teacher, obviously that 10-year vet teacher is going to get paid more. So it really does vary. It even varies by the district and the same city. So I cannot give you an answer to that question, because I live in San Antonio, and I'm sure there's another, city. Austin is around me, so Austin's about an hour and change away. So I'm sure they pay their teachers different, and it just depends on the school district. Okay, question number five. What did your daily work schedule consist of as a TA? As a teacher assistant, I basically help the teacher during the day, manage the kids, manage behaviors. I helped, clean up. I helped with some of the goals that were written. I helped her do some of the goals and take data. What else did I do? It was basically like whatever she wanted me to do, I did. And then of course, regular things like clean, like obviously clean, taking the kids to the bathroom, things of that nature, heating up their lunches. I wasn't allowed to do certain things, like really give too much details to the parents and confidentiality. So it was just pretty much helping the teacher. That's five, right? Okay, question number six. And I'm just grabbing random questions, y'all. So if I don't get to your question in this video, I'll get to it in the next video. Number six, what are some tips you recommend for people looking to become a teacher? What are some tips do I recommend for people looking to become a teacher? I would say do your research. Do a lot of research on basically teachers' rights. I'm gonna start there. Teachers' rights. That's where you need to start. Like, honestly, because there's a lot of things that you aren't aware of, and especially if you're starting as a first year teacher and you're going into the school, principal might be telling you one thing, and but you're reading something else. Know your rights. That is probably the first tip that I recommend. Secondly is look around to as many schools as possible. Do not jump on the first job that hires you unless you're extremely desperate. But weigh your pros and cons. Read your employee handbook. I'm just like, read everything. Read everything that you sign, all of that, because you have more rights than what you're led on to believing. So definitely, those are some tips that I would say. It's not too much about the kids, classroom management, because I think anybody can manage a classroom. I think you can, get used to managing a classroom. It's things that are outside of the classroom that you guys definitely need to do your research on. Okay, question number seven. Let's pick you. Are there any other job programs besides Texas Teachers? There is. I'm not aware of their names, so I'm so sorry. But I've only heard of maybe two other programs. So yeah, but there is. What am I on? Question number eight. Did you have support or training on how to write IEPs? At the beginning of the school year, absolutely not. I had no training on that. I did have support by asking, but if you didn't ask, then you were on your own. So, but there was no training. No one actually sat with me or new teachers and was like, okay, this is what we're gonna do. That didn't happen until later on in the school year that we did get training, but it was after there were some errors, in goal writing. So at the beginning there was not, but after there was, and if I asked for help, I was able to receive it. So definitely, do seek help on IEPs. Don't sit and try and do it alone, or ask for a training. You can ask, like, can I get trained on this? Or you can seek outside trainings as well outside in the community. I'm sure that your regional centers probably have trainings for that. Question number nine. Let's see. Are there any books, podcasts, or YouTube videos that helped you become a better teacher? No. No. The only thing that helped me actually become a better teacher, was probably Pinterest and Teachers Pay Teachers because of the resources. That is it. Okay, question number 10. Let's do this one. For paid internship, do you get regular teacher pay or is it lower? You do get regular teacher pay during your probationary period. So whatever other teachers got at the start entry level is the same thing I got paid. Texas Teachers does take out money from your check because during your probationary period, you do have a fee that you have to pay to them. I believe it was around 4 grand. If I'm not mistaken, it was around $4,000, and you pay that within your first year of your internship, and it came out of every check for me. So every check they took out $195. So I'm gonna say $200 every check. So every month I got $400 less than what I really would be getting, at the school. So yeah, Texas Teacher does take out their portion, but other than that, you get paid exactly what an entry-level teacher does get paid at that school. So I've answered 10 questions, y'all, and I have more. So I am gonna have to do a separate video because I don't want to ramble on in this video. I really wanted to make it short. But hopefully you guys will stay tuned and see part two of this Q&A video, and I'll talk to you later. And if you need me to elaborate on some of the questions, leave a comment below and I will. Make sure you subscribe, stay tuned, because part two will be here pretty soon. Bye-bye.